On this S15 headlight, you might notice something very interesting. You can see some shadows going on over here, same here as well. And for this indicator, the black housing is getting lit up in just the right places. And the way how all of this is done is just with an emissive texture, with some baked lighting. This is a very accurate way to calculate how your headlight gets lit up, and you can do it straight from Blender. Now, I did need to spice it up a bit in Photoshop, just giving it a bit of colors, but by the end of this video, you will be able to make your very own emissive texture with some baked lighting. The first thing to do would be to hide any objects that you don't need, like transparent ones that will block any light. What you might be thinking of doing is hiding them with this eye icon, but this is a common mistake. This will actually do nothing when it comes to rendering. So what you want to do instead is hide them with the camera icon, like these ones. Better yet, if you have them all in a collection like here, you can just press on this check mark and it will disable everything there is about them. Second, here's our object. Make sure there's no major overlaps in our UV map. So to check for that, you want to select here, select overlap, and this will highlight any overlaps in your UV. In our case, it's fine. Third, you need to create a new material for your object here. It has to be done in a very specific way. So hit new. The base color, make sure this is white. Metallic, make sure this is not one. So 0 is fine. If you have a normal map, you can use it like so. Image texture, and then use it here. But I don't have one, so I can remove it like so. And lastly, the texture, you need to spawn it in. So on the base color, hit on this yellow dot, image texture, new. I'm going to call it diffuse. And the resolution, try not to go too crazy with this, because the bigger the texture, the longer it will take for you to render it. 512 is fine, so I'm going to hit new image. And lastly, very important step, click on this new texture that you created and hit disconnect. Not remove, disconnect. And that should prepare your material. It should spawn in your image texture here, but it shouldn't be connected. And it should also be your active texture, as you can see by the white outline. Fourth, you want to prepare the compositor for denoising. So you want to hit use nodes. You can delete this one. What you want to do is spawn in your image, like so. Diffuse, that's the one that we created. And you want to connect it to a denoiser. Denoise image, like so. Just connect it like so. This compositor will now denoise your output when you hit F12. Fifth, we will now adjust our render settings. So first things first, the engine, that needs to be cycles. The device, you can use your GPU. The viewport, this doesn't really matter, just changes how much it renders in your viewport. I like to turn off noise threshold and set this to be a very low number. 2 or 4 is fine, I'm gonna go with 2. Render, this is the important one. The higher this number, the more time it will take for you to render your texture. So for now, let's keep it at a very low number, so 16, and we will crank this up later. Denoise doesn't work for baked textures as of today. And if you scroll down, we have the bake menu. Turn this from combined to diffuse. And down in color management, make that standard, the view transform. And in the second tab, the output, change the resolution to be the same exact resolution as you've had for your texture. So if you remember, we chose 512. We're going to make it 512 here as well. And in this world tab, you want to change the background color from this shade of gray or whatever it may be to black. At this point, everything should be set up, which means you can just click on your object, go to this bake drop-down menu, and press this big bake button. There you go, and now you can press F12 to run your compositor. And there you have it, that's your texture. You may have noticed that it's all black, and that's fine, because we don't have any lights in our scene, which is what we'll be doing next. Sixth, we will now spawn in some lights into our scene. So I'm going to create a new collection, just to stay organized, I'm going to call it high beams. Shift A, light, point, I'm going to move it into place. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with that placement. I may need to change a few settings around, so I want to make sure the point light is selected and go into this tab with the bulb icon. And I recommend turning off normalize and giving it a bit of radius, because that's how you can get some softer shadows. So to preview this, you can just hold down Z and move your mouse up to rendered. Yep, that looks okay. I may need to make it a bit more powerful, so let me just raise this to 30. Yeah, that's fine, I think. So now we have some lights in our scene. And now it's finally time for us to bake this light onto our object here. So I'm going to select it, go into this tab, scroll all the way down here to this big bake button, press that, and I'm going to press F12 to run my compositor. There you go. You can see the compositor is trying its best to denoise it, but it's not doing a good job. That's fine. You just want to double check that, you know, everything looks fine. You have some very bright spots and also some very dark spots. This is your last chance to make any changes. So if you're happy with it, you can just scroll back up, go into render, and crank this up to be a very high number. Let's go with 512, I guess. Yeah. Bake again and just give it a while. There you go. And you want to press F12. And there you go. That's a lot crispier. So now you can actually like just save this texture anywhere. This is all fine. And there we have it. That's our texture. Now, if you were to use your texture as it is right now, you might notice that it doesn't quite light things up correctly. And that's happening because for KNPP lights, the emissives, they cannot brighten up the black areas on your base texture. Like you can see here, this area is black, this is white. It can only light up the white part. So when you turn off that kind of behavior, you get this, which is a lot closer to what we're after. To do that, you will need to tweak the car lights shader, which should be located here in assets, content, car parts, and then shaders. So let's duplicate it. Name it whatever you want, it doesn't matter. Double click it, and you want to bypass these four nodes. So delete these ones and just reconnect the split node into the multiply nodes here. So like that. And that's it. Control S to save it. And now you can use this shader on your materials. If you're too lazy to do that, you can just grab the shader that I posted in the ministry. It has the four nodes that we deleted as a checkmark here. And other than that, you should be set. So have fun.